Hi guys, so this morning I did get some things in. Actually, the last couple days I just haven't done a haul for it, but most of the stuff is Autoship stuff, so I'll show you guys that, and then of course I'll get to the reviews. If I have any links in the description box, there will be affiliate links, which means I'll make a small commission if you use any of those links to make any purchases, but maybe the Arteza stuff. I don't even know what I have here, to be honest. I just have a bunch of stuff that came in and it's sitting around me. I just want to show you these cards that I made the last couple days. And I love these cards. So make sure to check out the tutorials on them. This one's real simple. Just, you know, using some Crafting Companion stuff, some Diamond Press stuff. And then this one had some steps to it. But, oh my gosh, if it's not, like, the cutest thing, I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So this is the tonic one. So definitely want to check that out if you have a minute. Yeah, so let's just get started. Let me grab this Arteza. I think the reason I have an idea that I have more Arteza stuff than I thought, it's because they sent some items for review. So I'll show you that, guys, those things later. But I did pick up the other pencil case. So I have the first one. Actually, I'll show it to you right here because I have both of them now. And because I'm a lazy person, I didn't even zip this one. But I have this one, the splatters, and I love this case. And right now it's holding all kinds of different things. I think it has all my acrylic paint pens from Arteza, and then it has a ton of gel pens are all in here. Oh, they're up here and all throughout the whole thing. And so that's one of them. And then I just recently picked up this guy so I can put my Spectrum Noir, my new Spectrum Noir tri-blends in there. And I had mentioned I got mine on HSN, but right now Craft Stash has a really great price on the whole kit. I'm trying to see where my kit is. Where did I put those pens? Okay. I don't know where they are at the moment, but somebody had asked if they fit in here, and I did a review a while back on the other case, and I showed that those pens do fit, but let me see if I can grab one. Oh, here they are. Oh my gosh, stuff is definitely gonna fall. Okay. So I would just take my pens. I do love the case that Crafters Companion themselves makes, and it's awesome. But, you know, I haven't seen it available recently. And this one is inexpensive, and it holds your pens perfectly well. And as you can see, they fit to the very edge. But this has, obviously, space around it. So I'll have them in here. Oop. So I had mentioned that part of what I like about these pens is that they're easier to open. The old tri-blends sometimes, and again, be very careful when you pin these back in. You would try to pull it open and it would pull this whole nib out and you'd end up with the whole thing that, you know, holds the ink in your, seeing that and the nib is still over here. This whole thing would pull out. So these are kind of a lot easier in that regard, but be careful. So I grabbed that. What else did I get for my teaser? I know I ordered something else myself, but I don't see it here right now. I order stuff on their site, what's it called? Dry erase markers and things like that that aren't super exciting, and, you know, I just don't show them on here, but they do have a lot of, like, office supplies type things, and right now with the kids, there's just a ton of things. My son's like, Arteza has a really good quality stuff, which made me laugh because it's like, he's 11 years old. That's a funny comment. But anyway, so let's get to the stuff that I recently picked up. So I think these two things I ordered and everything else is auto ship. So there's a lot of auto ship. Let me see. Da-da-da. Yeah. So what is this? Okay, so this is auto ship. I was trying to keep it separate, but I guess it doesn't really matter. This is an interesting little package. Suppose I could reuse it because it's easy to open. What is this? Oh, cool. I didn't know it was going to be like this. This is a super clearance item from, all the stuff is HSN, that Craft Couture, or Couture Creations, that's what it's called. And it was only like 11 bucks or so, and I really wanted the dragonfly. But how cute, the way they're packaged. So it's a little dragonfly and then some foliage type stuff that you can put in the corners. This one's more of a laurel kind of looking thing. A little corner that you fold over so it makes like a little pocket or however you want to use it. It just says folding corner butterfly. Really pretty leaf. That's really stylized, like the way it's like several leaves, but it's the one die. And then just for you, all stuck together. That's cute. Okay, well, I guess I'm going to keep things not. I don't know what the other. Hold on, is it this one? No, that's auto ship. Okay, well. Oh, well. This is the Autoship. Yes. Excuse me, I got a little something in my throat. This is the decorative corner dies, or however they want to call them, Autoship. So, really cute. This one has the little flowers, and this one has a little honeycomb. And I have picked up some of these, like, through craft session things. They don't have them all, and then sometimes, and Sarah says, some things will be specifically only on HSN, so I reset up my Autoship to skip the ones I haven't picked up. To skip the ones I have picked up, and then if I don't have them, I have them coming in through HSN, so that's kind of how I set that up. But like I said, always set up your Autoship. As soon as you order an item, the Autoship will be in your Autoship manager, and you've just watched the demo, and you know exactly what you want to keep or not. You can go and do that, and the whole time that, you know, if it's a year long or however many, you can still skip and, customize however you want to do that. This is the Diamond Press Autoship for the Marquise. So I know at Diamond Press they're very generous with me and they send me all the different things, but I wanted to make sure that I was going to get all of the Autoships, and sometimes they send them, sometimes they don't. So I bought a Marquise, which reminds me, I have an extra Marquise set that, I'm keeping my extra Marquise. I got it in gold, and then I have the coral one that Diamond Press sent me. But everything else that comes with that I could destash. So anyhow, so this is the Autoship for August, and I'm really excited to try it out, so we will definitely do that. But it looks like the frame this time has like little stars, and then it has all these things, and all these things you can mix and match with the previous months and with did the Marquise come with something that started off with it? I thought it did, but I don't want to misspeak, so we'll check that out. So of course I'll review that soon. This is the square card dies Autoship number 1 from Anna Griffin. So I had gotten there. I had made a video review of this already, but I love it already. I just think it's so pretty. It has the little medallion and this, and it's very similar, obviously, to the first one. So if you like this kind of thing, you'll like it. If you don't, then, you know, it's just not, it's more of the same, basically, of the, but look how pretty. So I will review that very soon. I think the first thing I'll review is the box, the Crafter's Companion box. Oh, yeah. So this... Yeah, there's Autoship too. The decoupage flowers. So I did a video for the last set, and it was more like, I guess like a flower spray, like daisies, I think. I don't really remember. Look how pretty. Oh, I love that. Oh my gosh. So there's the lovely lilies set. And again, all the papers in here are exactly the same. Supposedly they have some that you can download on their site, and then you could have different colors or however. Or I don't know if they're different colors or more of the same. I thought she said different colors, but who knows. And then we have the dies. So the dies can make your own lilies if you want from the stamps, all right? So you have the stamps, and you have the dies, and then these same dies will also cut the paper. So really cool stuff. I have reviews on all the other ones, but of course I will get to this soon. That's so pretty. I love the colors on that. Oh, okay, yeah. So this is the last Autoship, and then the other item is something I just ordered the other day. So I want to mention about this. If you just signed up for the Autoship, I don't think you're going to get this box. So remember how they just opened it up and they had the 3 boxes for like $50 plus shipping, so you got one box free basically. When you go to see your Autoship schedule, I don't think you're getting this one. I think it's starting with the next in September, but I could be wrong on that. It seems that's the case. So this is the Modern Edgeables Craft Kit number 27. And I think if you just signed up, you're going to start with number 28, although you got the other boxes that they just gave you or sent you when you made your purchase. So I will definitely open this up. Obviously, I'll probably do the review right now after I'm done with this and get it going. Already the colors are a little bright for me, but I do like the little swirl here with the butterfly, and then it has like a happy birthday. So it's a couple of edgeables, basically modern edgeables, as you can see there. So I will get to reviewing this today in just a bit. And then this thing, I was like, why is this box so big? It's a huge box. So I was surprised. I'm like, what is this? It is an Anna Griffin set. Let me try to open this guy up. Oh, no wonder. See, I don't know. I didn't see her a demo on this or anything. I guess she did demo it, but I wasn't paying attention. So I just saw that. I thought it was pretty. And so I ordered it. Again, in a gorgeous box. nice box. Bountiful birthday card making kit. Now, to be honest, I forgot that it said birthday. I was like, oh, this will be great because it has kind of like a fall theme, but I guess it's for birthdays in the fall. And I don't know that I have that many birthdays in the fall. We'll see what this looks like, but I'll review this too. It's not super fallish. It's like this one. Okay, see, that's very fall, right? But like this one, I don't see anything particularly fall about this one or that one. Okay, so maybe that's okay. So pretty. And again, just packed with pretty, pretty stuff. So I'll review that one soon too. I'm trying to think of something else here. Is that it? I feel like there's more than this, but oh well. Okay, I know I'm waiting for a few orders from Craft Stash that I recently placed, and oh, one other one. What's the other one? I can't think right now. My brain is like, eh. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I will have the reviews going. Keep an eye out. In just a little bit, I'll have the review up for the Modern Edgeables Craft Kit. And yeah, so I guess it's a go for Saturday with Crafter's Companion. I changed some things behind me because I think I'm going to set up my camera to be in front of me over there facing this way. And so, you know, whenever I do videos, if I'm on camera, I kind of stand over here. But I guess you don't really know that, but I'm standing over here. So I have some cute things. And then I used, oh, let me show you these little clippies. Where are they? Where did I put them? Oh, well, I'll just grab one. I went ahead and stuck some things on my wall so I can, I made some, so I can hang these. Remember these are from MelissaFrances' site? She had them on clearance for like $1 or $2, I don't know. And I have these little guys left. I might still hang these up behind me. But I put them on the wall and then I hung cards that I made, you know, Crafter's Companion cards behind me. So it's kind of something that'll be showing back there. Hopefully it'll be noticeable, I don't know. Super cute. I did a few just to have a couple cards there sitting behind me. So really cute clippies. If you haven't seen these, I will put links for these. These I purchased on my own, but Melissa Francis in the past has sent items for review, but these weren't part of that. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you all the next one. I hope everyone is doing well, especially out in the Gulf Coast and obviously everyone across the country dealing with everything we deal with every day. But yeah, I'll see you guys at the next one. Bye now.